tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, John Richardson, Sara Pascoe, Richard Ayoade, Nick Helm, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jim.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's team captain John Richardson. Oh. John, if you're here, who's back at your house desperately trying to persuade your wife not to leave? And John's teammate this evening, Sara Pascoe. Sara is a vegan, so she's always making people who visit her vegetables. Bit like Sean, but he does it with a hammer.
I get away with it.
Up against them this evening, it's team captain Sean Locke. Sean Locke, he's taking a countdown like a duck to snooker. And joining Sean tonight, it's Richard Ayoade. Richard Ayoade, if he was any stiffer, we'd have to pixelate him. Can I ask you, Sean, do you have any celebrity beefs?
Loads. Paloma Faith.
What's your issue with Paloma?
All I said... All I said was she had a shit hat... ..and she's a pound shop Bjork. And then... Oh, kaboom.
That's so mean.
Yoko Ono. Come on, woman, you're talented. We want another album. Get out there and do it. Nick Knowles. Though money.
What did you...
Nick makes his own Viagra. In a lockup. And,
right.
It's good. But it's too good. It's like rigor mortis. I said, you haven't tested this on anyone, have you? I said, I'm not paying for this until it's been rigorously tested, so we've fallen out. Tom Hanks, because he keeps... I bought an audio book. You know he does these audio books?
Mm-hmm.
I got this audio book of him. He keeps gulping. And Stephen Hawking, the same problem, but not... gulping, because I've got his audiobooks. He did Brief History of Time.
Yeah.
And cheeky bugger, because he knows nobody finishes it. Halfway through it, he just starts humming.
OK, John, is there any John Richardson merchandise available, you know, for your fans?
Very little official. There's stuff knocking about on the dark web. There's a few sort of crotchless Swansea cardigans that have got my face on, but they're nothing to do with me. I have to make that very clear. I have things I'm launching that are mine. The Rico Sphere we're working on at the moment, which is like it creates a sort of John Richardson atmosphere in any room. So it's a bit like a dehumidifier, but for fun. So we're working on those. And the one thing we're very excited about is my scented candle. Which is, we're a bit late because Gwyneth got hers out first, the old vagina candle. So I've got one that smells of my testicles. But sadly, the day we did the lab day, I'd just had a bath. So it's just a lavender candle. Just a few pubes on it. Just another sense of authenticity.
It'd be a nice thing for visitors, like, smell that. What do you think that is?
Yeah. John Richardson's left testicle. They come in a pack of two, left and right. Double in the profit.
Sara, what's the most important life lesson you've ever learnt?
Oh, this is quite recently. Never give your address out to Lily Allen. I got a phone call saying Lily Allen would like to make you feel more sexually empowered. Can she have your address?
Of course she would.
A couple of hours later, doorbell goes, and there's a man there, and he's really, really blushing because he's holding a bag that says, I masturbate. Down it in really large letters, and he can't park anywhere near my house, so he's had to walk like a really long way. And then I didn't think, I just put it down in the hall, the bag, and but my dog found it, ripped it all apart, took it out in the garden. I didn't realise, so I looked out the window, and the dog is playing on the lawn with a dildo. I didn't feel very sexually empowered at all. And eventually, threw the bag away with the obviously ruined dildo. But then what happened was, when the recycling men came, they were very sloppy, and the bag fell out. and it was going up and down the road in the wind. I didn't see it, but it had my address on it. So someone came and put it on my doorknob, and so I came home and it just said, I masturbate outside the front door. And now I can't masturbate anymore without thinking about Lily Allen.
She's got her own brand sex toys, the Womanizer, which I believe is named after John Richardson, isn't it?
I mean, how much can you polish up a sex toy? I mean, how much can you improve it?
Well, no, it's a suction.
Yeah.
I feel 38 years in, I just got to grips with sex and what it was. But isn't that what you do to a man? You suck.
No, you blow on the man, you blow. Man likes to be blown. But no, I just think, obviously, that's a very cynical celebrity ploy, isn't it? That thing where they go, I'm helping women liberate themselves.
Oh, I see.
No, I'm shifting some fucking gear, mate. That's basically what she's doing. She's going, I'm liberating women. No, you're not. You made a few quid, love.
I'll be honest with you, Sean, I don't think you'd get away with it.
I challenge Lily Allen now. We'll see who is the master sex toy designer.
What would your brand name be? I mean, would it just be...
Lock and Load?
I haven't really thought about it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
No more than 20%. No more.
Yeah. Richard, apparently you're in the new Star Wars series, The Mandalorian. So what do you play, like a Jedi or a cool sort of Han Solo figure?
Well, I play a droid. They didn't actually have to put any treatment on my voice. I already sound like a robot. So it was a very easy experience in and out, and I didn't have to visit the set or speak to anyone or be near it.
Can I ask a question? I would love an honest answer here.
Yes.
Have you seen The Mandalorian that you're in?
No.
If I was in it, I'd definitely watch it.
Right.
You're in it. What more do you need Disney to do to get you to watch a Star Wars thing?
Me being in it is like a kryptonite for me.
Yeah.
I have to live with this. Why would I want it reflected back at me?
Okay. Richard, have you got a mascot this evening?
I'm wearing it.
What have you done?
It's my lucky cast.
Well, hang on. It's got a calculator on it.
That's what brings me the luck.
Well, you can't have a calculator on Countdown. That's not in the rules.
That is not good luck. Okay, well, I've always got a backup, regular, non-calculator cast.
You've actually broken your arm?
Yes.
How'd you break your arm?
I was fighting for justice.
Could you be slightly more specific?
Well, justice? Well, justice.
Less specific, isn't it?
National justice.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes. Of course, during the lockdown, I've had to look for new revenue streams because obviously the comedy business has dried up.
Right.
So I thought I'd go back to what I was good at before.
What were you doing before?
Modelling. I was quite a successful male model. To let you know how famous and successful I was, I had one name, I was just called by it.
What was the name? What were you known by?
I didn't think that up. Richard?
Cliff?
Cliff. I was Cliff. Cliff. And, I had a really good career and it was going really well until I had the accident and I had to give up modelling.
What was the accident?
Well, I was doing a tour of the Canistan factory. you do a tour of a brewery. And
how are you pronouncing Canistan?
Canistan.
Canistan, you know, the country in the Middle East.
I fell in the vat. And it's not really clear what happened. But nobody wanted to offer me any work after that. It just sort of dried up. So I thought, I'd better go back to modelling, but I can't obviously do the facial stuff anymore. So I had to do sort of a bit more resourceful, do other bits of my body. This is my one I do for toenail infections.
And that's your foot, is it?
That's my foot.
Oh.
So I'll tell you what one of the ironies is. They asked me to be the... not the face of Canistan. I was asked to be the crotch of Canistan. And that's like full circle.
I would not describe that as a full circle, but yeah, that's...
It's a semicircle.
And with that money, I bought a hot tub. Which actually made it worse. Of course, I do a lot of plaque work and gum disease.
Let's have a look. Ooh.
But if someone says to you, a month, don't brush your teeth, you go, yeah. I saw the numbers. This one is for just a horrible tongue.
Oh, God!
What even is that?
The stuff I had to lick. The things I had to lick to get my tongue like that, you would not believe. You know when people run marathons?
Yeah.
They get jogger's nipple.
Oh, right.
Who do they use?
Could you hold that just a little bit lower for me? Over a bit. No, the other way. Yeah. Oh, that's perfect. Isn't that the money shot there.
That's an album cover by the Libertines.
Sure luck, everyone. Thank you. Sarah, did you bring a mascot this evening?
I did.
Well, what have you got?
Well, I thought a lot about how I wanted to be better at the games, and I thought about the cleverest person that I know, and that is my dog, Mouse. So I've got a picture of him. This is what he looks like. If you want to see what he looks like in, like, three dimensions, this is like a little statue.
So you've had a statue and a portrait done of your dog?
Yeah.
You know you can just stuff them.
Is that what I'm doing too? So I thought about channeling my dog's cleverness, and it works on two levels, because actually when you say a dog's a clever boy, good boy, usually they've just sniffed something or eaten something and everyone's like, oh, he's so clever. So I thought I'd dress up as my dog. Even if I get 0 points, you'd be like, well, that dog's playing Countdown. Clever girl, what a good... Do you see? Oh, I found some more pictures of him. Actually, this is a real-life photograph. He had the same modelling agent as Sean. Look at him. Isn't that the most handsome dog you've ever seen? Well, I'm going to become him. These are my paws.
I mean, I love my dogs, but this feels like a problem.
I love him so much, Jimmy. So, look, now, when I'm doing Countdown, like, it's just my dog doing his maths. And then you're like, what a clever dog!
OK, well, that'll bring you good luck, I feel sure.
Yeah.
John, have you got a mascot?
Well, I mean, hands up, Jimmy, I didn't. I didn't have one. So, anyway, I got here a bit early and I nipped to, you know, the second-hand shop next to the studio. It's opposite the ancient burial ground. You know that one? And they only had one thing left, would you believe it? And it was this. So I just managed to pick this up and it feels like... I was just meant to find it. And I thought, we could be like a double act. I call him Richard Johnson.
Oh, I don't like its eyes.
It's your fucking problem with my eyes!
Oh, it's genuinely creepy.
Yeah, I don't like it, John. I don't think you should
I like the voice, though.
I think you shouldn't be messing with this kind of voodoo stuff.
There's nothing... I don't understand. People keep saying it. I keep showing people it. I showed my daughter it this morning. She went, fucking bananas.
You didn't wake her up with it, did you?
Yeah. Good morning! He loves a one-liner, so he's going to do some gags. He loves a blue joke. Hey, who wants to hear a joke?
Yeah,
love to hear a joke.
Hey, you know they discovered diarrhea is hereditary?
No, I hadn't heard that.
Hey, it runs in your jeans! Runs in your fucking jeans! Do one for Susie that's about words. All right, then, Susie, you'll like this. I shit myself on a campsite the other day, and as I was running to the toilet...
Is it not running to the toilet?
No, I was on a campsite, so you're always going past tense.
Oh, very good.
OK, well, that's it here. I'll help you with letters as well. Okay.
John Richardson, everyone. Over in Dictionary Corner, it's Nick Helm. We put Nick Helm in Dictionary Corner, which makes about as much sense as booking an orangutan to perform your laser eye surgery. Nick, what have you been up to since we last saw you?
Hello, Jimmy.
Hello, Nick.
What have I been up to? Mainly, I've been, like, moving on. I've got a girlfriend now.
Really? Where's she from?
She's from Canada. Her name's Alice Quebec. And she is a hockey player who works in a maple syrup factory at the weekend. And we're in love.
And she's
gorgeous.
Yeah. Good.
Who's gorgeous? Because when you said she's gorgeous, you were looking directly at Susie Dent there. Because you used to like Susie, didn't you?
Yeah, used to.
Come on! It's been a long year. It's been a shit old year, hasn't it, Jimmy? We all got a fucking... we've got to move on with our lives, don't we?
And with Nick, of course, is Susie Dent. Susie's latest book was printed with a load of mistakes. How could that happen? Well, I imagine the proofreader kept falling asleep. We all know you tweet a word of the day. What's today's word, Susie?
This one was just random because, you know, I like to read the dictionary and I came up with this great word, which is commiferous.
Commiferous, yeah. Oh, I like it already.
Yeah, and you will like this one because it means bearing locks of new hair.
No, it's not new, it's just been redistributed.
But that's how you can describe yourself from now on.
What is it again?
Commiferous. It's got cum in it, so you like it. C-O-M-E-F-O-U-S.
And in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. Last year, Rachel gave birth to a baby girl. She was in labour for 3 hours, but then left because of all the anti-Semitism. Rachel, you're a big Man United fan. Are you hoping the baby's going to be a fan too?
Definitely. I was really proud. We finally got to sit down and watch a game because she's only little. It was Man United against Tottenham. United scored first and she was actually clapping. I was really proud. And then it got to 4-1 to Tottenham and she clapped every single goal. She just likes clapping. She was clapping Trump rallies and all sorts. She just was great. At
what age do you find out if a baby is evil? She might just be really horrible.
And Sarah angling to be godmother.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Breakdancing Kit. Okay, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John, Sarah, you get the first pick of the letters.
I'll start with a consonant, please.
A consonant? Sure. Very good for a dog.
Another consonant.
S.
One vowel.
A.
And then one consonant.
T.
And then another consonant.
R.
And then one vowel.
E.
One more consonant.
L.
And one more vowel.
O.
And one more consonant. Thank you.
And an N.
OK. For the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Get the seafood platter. Thank you. It's all right from that camera, but from that shot, this looks kind of wrong. Found it in Susie's dressing room.
Lily Allen sent it.
That's what happens after you take Nick Knoll's secret Viagra.
John, how many letters?
Seven.
Sarah, how many?
Seven.
Richard, how many?
Seven.
Sean?
Six.
Sean, what's your six?
Strobe.
Strobe. OK, Richard, you're seven?
Lobster.
Lobster. Lobster's an excellent word. John, you're seven?
Blaster.
OK, and Sarah, what was your word?
Mine's an anagram of lobster. Bolster.
7 points to both teams. Magnificent work. You got seven there, which is good. But
that's
seven
the end of it.
For a dog, that is really remarkable.
That's it. You might be feeling proud of yourself for your seven. Then you remember, oh, a two-year-old dog got the same score as you.
For a man who's only hired for his lack of humanity, it is impressive.
Richard, you're making me really sad.
I know, that's what's lovely about a dog being there, because they do respond to emotions.
OK, Nick, Susie, could they have done you better?
They could have got an eight, couldn't they? They could have got storable.
Oh.
Yes, I know. And
baronets, also.
OK, on to our first numbers round. Sean, Richard, you get to pick the numbers.
Usual, please.
Two biggies and four little ones.
Right, here
nine,
we go.
Nine, five, seven, and three. And the big one, 75 and 25. And the target, 741.
Your time starts now. The target was 741. Richard, did you get it?
Maybe, yes.
Maybe, yes, OK. Sarah, did you get it?
Yeah.
John, did you get it?
Yeah, we got it.
Sean, did you get it?
Sure thing. Sure thing, partner.
I was worried that we didn't have, like, an old Western sort of feel to the show, but...
Stagecoach came through just about an hour ago there.
How did you do it in that voice, please?
Oh, what I did was I took about seven of my three, and then I times that with the 75, and then I took off the nine. I took off the nine.
Nice.
Skills. Sarah, did you do it the same way?
The same way.
Okay, so both teams have 17 points. And here is your teaser. The words are nuts hero. The clue is I'm heading down. That's nuts hero. I'm heading down. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were nuts hero. The clue was, I'm heading down. It was, of course, Southern. OK, so both teams have 17 points. On to another letters game. Sean, Richard, your turn to choose.
Four vowels and five consonants.
U-I-E-O-W-G-P and then S and T.
Your time starts now. Hey, rabbit. Shh, have a carrot. Okay, have a few. You're a hungry boy. You're a hungry boy. You're a greedy boy, yes you are. Yes you are, greedy boy. Come on, greedy boy. Come on, greedy boy. Yeah. You're a hungry little fella, aren't you? Yeah, eat it all up. Come on, have a big one. You greedy fat bastard. I think I've overfed it. What happened was, there was a mix-up. Susie ordered a giant rabbit off Amazon, and this turned up. I mean, that is a cute rabbit, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, this one, we're taking very good care of this one. After this, we just filmed for a couple of seconds with it, and then we're going to give it a nice bath backstage with carrots and onions.
And also, oh, yeah, isn't frightened cold. Of the dog, which is nice.
I reckon this rabbit could take you.
Maybe.
Oh, bye-bye, rabbit. Well, love you. Sweet. Love you, rabbit.
Aww. You know, John Ronson did that podcast and found out about people who, like, pay for niche porn. I've just found out mine is a man feeding a carrot to a rabbit.
Has that awoken that's something within you?
I would pay a lot of money just for a fully dressed man, actually in a suit, worked, feeding a carrot to a rabbit, saying it was a nice rabbit.
Get the rabbit back. I think she was nearly finished. Richard, what have you got?
Five.
Sean, what did you get?
Five.
John?
We got a six, but we don't think it's a word.
Sarah, how many?
Yeah, I wasn't playing because I was looking at you and the rabbit.
OK, Sean, what's your five?
Swipe.
OK. Richard, your five?
Guest.
John, your six?
Well, I don't know if it's a word or if it's spelt like this, but it feels like it should be a word. Spigot.
Mmm.
Spigot.
Yeah.
Susie Dent straight with a yeah. Yeah. Yeah, spigot's a yeah. word. What does spigot mean, Susie Dent?
Spigot's like the tap on a cask or a barrel.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Very good.
6 points to John. A spigot. Nick, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, yeah, they could have got an eight.
What was the eight?
You're going to kick yourself, guys. It was wipeouts.
Oh, oh, wow.
Lovely, ah, yeah.
Lovely stuff.
OK, so, well, at the end of that, Sean and Richard have 17, John and Sarah have 23. Right, time for another numbers game. John, Sarah, your turn to choose. John, I've seen a lot of horror films with puppets like this. Are you not worried about it jumping into your body?
Think I want to change bodies with that balding, saggy mess. Get to bugger it.
Freaking it. I wasn't even touching it, mate. We will have one big one, please, Rachel.
And five little ones. Your numbers are 3, 5, 1, 4, 8, and the big one, 75. And the target, 273.
Okay, and your time starts now. Ooh. John, what happened?
What have you done with him?
I haven't done anything.
Fuck's it gone? Never mind.
Did you get it?
273, Jimmy.
Sarah, did you get it?
Yeah.
Sean, did you get it?
Yeah, I got it, yeah.
And Richard, did you get it?
I think so.
OK. Richard, how did you do it?
4 times 8 is 32. +1 is 33.
Yeah.
75 plus 5 times 3.
Yeah, haven't used any of those. 240.
240, and then you add those.
That'll do.
Brilliant. Wow. Did you get it in the same way?
I got it a different way.
How did you get it?
75 times 4 is 300.
Yep.
And then I had a 3. 8 times 3 is 24, plus the 3 is 27, and I minus that from the 300.
What, sorry?
Did I not do it right?
Do you mean 8 plus 1 times 3?
And then minus that from 300.
That's what you meant, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Can anyone else smell bullshit? That's some bullshit right there.
This is a dog. A dog.
All right, so what was that? 10 points to both teams? 10 points to both teams. OK, so Sean and Richard have 27. John and Sarah are in the lead with 33. Time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Nick Helm, what have you got for us?
I'm going to do a song now.
Awesome.
Yeah, well, you say that. I wrote it before I got over Susie. It's off my forthcoming album, 100% Dent. So. Life is hard, now so am I. After all the words between us, all the books you made me buy. We've been playing games for years by now. I guess it's just a fact. You thought you broke my heart in two, but it barely even cracked. You hit me like an asteroid. You shot me with your dart. You didn't break me, baby, but there's a dent in my heart. There's a dent in my heart. Just a dent in my heart. I barely even noticed when you ripped my world apart. You sent me all those letters, the entire alphabet. But I'm partially dyslexic, so there's some I might forget. I've been sat beside you all this time, can't work out what's gone wrong. Don't understand the words you said, because your words were far too long. On a scale of mass distraction, when all is said and done, it's a tiny inconvenience. I guess I'll carry on. You trapped me like a dictionary from off the highest thing. You thought you crushed me, baby, but it barely made a ding. There's a test in my heart. Just a little dent in my heart. I made giving zero fucks look like a martial art. There's a dent in my heart. Yeah, my heart has a dent. You chipped this heart of stone a bit, but I fixed it with cement. There's a dent in my heart. Just a little dent in my heart. I barely even noticed when you ripped my world apart. There's a dent in my heart.
There's a dent in my heart. Just a dent in my heart. Perhaps someday I'll take you back, then we can restart. I'm really doing fine. Stop asking how I feel. I got a new Canadian girlfriend who is definitely real. Did a dent, did a dent, did a dent, did a dent, did a dent in my heart. Did a dent, did a dent, did a dent, did a dent, did a dent in my heart. Did a dent, 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 did a dent. A dent in my heart. There's a dent in my heart. Dent, dent, dent.
Wow. Yes, please. Nick Helm, everyone. That was fantastic.
Incredible pipes.
What did you, in the song, what do you drop the dictionary from?
High thing.
You don't get enough thing in modern music, I don't think.
I had to rhyme with ding.
It had to rhyme with ding. Yeah, a real glimpse behind the curtain of the songwriter there.
Bob Dylan, every song, he's working back from ding.
I'm still on the ding. Now I've got to go back.
That was fantastic, Nick. Incredible stuff. Super. The scores at the moment, Sean and Richard are on 27, John and Sarah in the lead with 33. And here is your teaser. The words are anus trim. The clue is it's all on show. That's anus trim, it's all on show. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were anus trim. The clue was it's all on show. It was, of course, naturism. OK, on to another letters game, and it's time to ramp up the tension. It's time for the tension round. In this game, we're playing for double points, so the pressure's on. Sarah, how do you react to pressure?
Pressure, I'm OK with. It's fireworks dogs are scared of, so I hope there's nothing loud.
John, you don't like the tension round normally,
nobody
but...
Nobody likes the tension round.
The viewers at home, the boys and girls at home, they love the tension round.
Yeah, I know, they've done a focus group.
Yeah. You're lucky it's not the 90s or you'd be gunged every time
I take gunge. Gunge is fine. I can shower off gunge. I cannot wash my soul of fear.
Look, I'll explain it to you now, OK? It's not that bad, right? During the tension round, we're playing for double points, so we make it slightly more difficult. That seems fair, right? So there are a few explosions through the tension round.
When? Okay.
But
on
also,
what second?
You're picking the letters, and one of the letters is booby-trapped.
Oh.
No, it's one letter out of 26, so if you pick that letter, there will be an explosion.
But it won't hurt Rachel, will it?
It's important to remember it doesn't matter. We're all insured.
To me.
Is the booby-trapped letter a vowel or a consonant?
I'm not sure. I can't remember.
Oh, you're an absolute piece of shit.
Hopefully we won't find out because it won't come up.
It'll be a vowel, won't it?
You think?
What sort of schmuck booby-traps a consonant?
Sean, have you got earplugs in?
Is it obvious? Have I
I would say you've got earplugs in, but they're sort of half in, I would say.
Stop me!
OK, I mean, they're in for good now. They are in for good. OK, John, you're picking the letters.
Consonant.
D.
Oh, no, I remember the booby trap.
Vowel.
E.
Of course it was going to be. What did I say? It's going to be a vowel.
You did say it was going to be a vowel. And it's almost like you're the man behind this, Sean. It's done now, so you've got nothing to worry about.
Consonant, then.
M.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
It's
They lied to us.
He lied to us.
Yeah, but would I lie again? That's what you've got to ask yourself.
Consonant, yeah. Please.
Z.
Vowel. You're fucking shitting cock. You,
When would you get...
Why did you go back when you knew that was going to happen?
Because we need a vowel that isn't an E.
Do you want to throw away that last E and then we'll get something...
Okay. No, don't touch it.
I fucking earned that E.
You've just got two E's. Another vowel.
I.
There you go.
A consonant, please.
T.
Ooh.
And a final vowel.
A final... A.
For double points, tension round. Your time starts now.
You are lying turd.
How many?
Seven.
Sarah, how did you do?
I got seven as well.
You got a seven as well?
Fear focused me, actually.
Fear focused you?
Yeah.
Very unusual for a dog.
Yeah.
Richard Ayoade, how'd you do?
I've only got five.
A five, OK. And Sean?
I go for a six.
OK. So, Richard, what's your five?
Rated.
Sean, your six?
Metered.
John, your seven?
Merited.
Very nice.
Sarah, you're seven?
It's tasered.
Tasered?
Yes.
Ooh.
Oh. Oh, but look.
Susie Dent, it's about to be a dick about things.
Oh, my God, is it not in the dictionary?
No, I just think it might be a trade name.
That's what I thought. That's why I didn't. I didn't want to infringe copyright.
Oh, no.
But if you're happy to start an IP war, Sarah, then you put down tasered.
It's a war with no bloodshed.
Mate.
The best kind.
Well.
Sorry, I'm going to be... the fun police, because it has to be with an S, because it's an acronym from Tom Swift's electric rifle.
Exactly. Basket.
No.
Basket.
I've even
tried it. Go to your basket.
I don't take all this from you.
Go to your basket.
You're just a guy I met on a train from Euston. You're not my owner.
Basket.
Okay.
She was up and down the aisle, defecating.
I didn't like it when she was dragging herself along the carpet.
OK,
So, I missed that. Why was tasered not allowed?
Susie, just explain this.
Take your earplugs out.
Yeah.
Oh, God! Hello, everyone. Of course, like a different world.
Basket.
OK, well, it's double points for the tension round, so that's 14 points for John and Sarah.
God. Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Nick, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
No, seven's the most. They could have had meatier.
Oh.
So, at the end of that round, John and Sarah are in the lead with 47 points. Just time to go across the literary corner one last time. Nick, what have you got for us?
I've got one poem. It's called Numbers. Numbers. A million zillion particles, 10,000 billion stars... 8 or 9 round planets, including Earth and Mars. 97 minutes make up Jingle All the Way. 100 works of literature and 50 Shades of Grey. 7 Harry Potter books, £9 in my bank. 1,000 souls who perished on the Titanic when it sank. 7 dwarves and 7 days, 7 deadly sins. 7 wonders of the world, 7 police academies. 4 fingers in a Kit Kat, or sometimes you get 2. There's 8 billion people out there, but only one of you. I can't believe you didn't lean all the way. That's absolutely...
I can't reach.
You'll get up.
You've come to see him in prison. Touch the screen.
Nick Helm, everyone. Here is your final teaser. The words are oral bits. The clue is just go round and round. That's oral bits. Just go round and round. See you after the break. Okay.
Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were oral bits. The clue was just go round and round. It was, of course, orbitals. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean, Richard, your turn to choose.
Rachel, can I have a vowel, please?
Of course you can, Sean. O.
And a consonant, please.
L.
And a vowel.
U.
And a consonant.
H.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
J.
A vowel, please.
A.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
And S.
OK, and your time starts now. Dear Diary, something really weird happened. I guess it happens to a lot of guys. I was in bed and I found myself enjoying one of Susie Dent's books. I feel a bit embarrassed and ashamed. It was full of fascinating facts, and she's a wonderful writer, but I've been slagging off her books for years. Maybe I should apologise and say something nice, but it's probably too late now. I'll think about it. Susie, I just want to say, in front of everyone, your books are shit.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Do you think anybody ever goes to buy one of your books and then remembers something that Jimmy said and goes, actually, I won't?
Maybe not.
Genuinely, I'll say this on the record, I've got a couple of them and I really like them and I'm obsessed by the podcast.
Are you?
I really like the podcast.
Oh.
Well, it's about time you told the lady.
I mean, I don't think there's any comedy value in this, but I really like it. Can I come on? It's fantastic. OK, Sarah, how many?
I've got five.
Five. OK, John?
I'll try a six, but I don't like it.
You don't need to push yourself on this, do you? Because you've already absolutely nailed it, 47 to 27. Sean, how many have you got?
I took that approach and went for jars.
Jars?
Yeah.
You went for jars?
I decided not to push myself, because John's already won.
Let me just check with Susie Dent if jars is a word. Is jars a word?
Yes.
Well, Sarah had... You had five, didn't you?
Five, yeah.
What did Richard have?
It was five.
Five. What was your five, Richard?
Hails.
Yeah.
Susie's quite bored by that, but yeah, okay. Sarah, yours?
I had shoal.
Shoal?
Like a shoal of fish.
Oh, that's a good word.
Yeah.
John, your six?
Well, I thought I'd try rousal.
Without the A?
Well, you can be roused and aroused.
Yeah.
So I wondered if you could have rousal and arousal.
I bet you can in historical dictionary, John.
Get it out from under the desk, mate, and let's celebrate.
It's not in this one, I'm afraid.
OK, sorry. 5 points to both teams. OK, so Sean and Richard have 32 points. John and Sarah have 52. OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Sean's got it. It's unusual for someone to come in before we've seen the mixed-up jumble, but what do you think it might be?
If you get it now, double points,
yeah,
and he wins the game.
100 million points, I reckon.
For 100 million points, what do you think the nine-letter word is?
OK.
Oh, bobsleigh.
Caretaker.
Oh, yeah, sure, yeah. You know.
No.
Really?
Think of something that, when you make an anagram of it, has got the word spunk or dick in it.
I mean, that's really reductive of the job that I do on this show. I feel that's really...
I'm excited to see what this
is. I feel that's a real cheap shot about the conundrum.
A cheap shot?
A cheap shot, like the idea that I just do it because it's like a rude word, and that's my whole raison d'etre.
I'm
look, your
so
time
sorry.
Starts now. Richard Ayoade.
Serum ball.
Okay, I'm going to restart the clock. You've got 6 seconds to make the magic happen. John Richardson.
Bum lasers.
It's not the right answer. You got like 3 seconds and something you might need in the rain. Oh. Sean?
Umbrellas.
Umbrellas.
Sean Locke got it.
Yes, for 1 million points.
1 million points.
For 1 million points.
The jeopardy of getting it before it's revealed compared to getting it when the clock's run out and you've been told the answer is slightly diminished.
I can't hear a damn thing this guy's saying.
Oh. Let's find out if Sean's right.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he's right. So that's 10 points to Sean.
10 million.
You're promising 10 million points.
I know we're 2 meters apart because of the rules, but quick chat about whose fucking side you're on.
Dogs are very loyal to like, everyone they've seen.
Right.
So I'm on everyone's team.
Yeah.
The real winner is Countdown. Yeah! And that's how you end, and that's how you end the show.
With a freeze frame.
Me punching the air.
So the final scores are Sean and Richard have 42, John and Sara have 52. So John and Sara are now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Breakdancing Kicks. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Live international cricket tomorrow morning, 3:45 a.m. to 11:30, with England's Test Tour of India. You can watch here on Channel 4 and live on All 4. Now, too much to Jean, never cast gets a taste of student life. And has Stephen kicked the bottle? Have a look in the hedge. Brand New Back is next.